What's up, Scentsy fans? It's Patricia. Today is Tester Tuesday, which is a weekly series of Scentsy review videos where I typically discuss two cents each week, and it helps me use up my testers and wax stash, and you guys get to help me by voting, so it makes it fun. So we had 357 votes come in last week, and in first place, we have this kind of neon green colored wax, or yellowy green, and with 37% of the vote, it is Casting Spells, a scent that is returning in January's Bring Back My Bar. And in second place, we have this dark green colored wax. This is a current scent. It is called Ice Pine, and it had 22% of the vote. So let's talk about our first place scent for the week. It is Casting Spells. Like I said, a green neon colored scent. On cold sip, I would say this is a medium, maybe even a medium plus in intensity. And it's coming back in January, and it was a former scent of the month, I believe from September 2016. I hope I'm right on that. I did look it up and now I forget. I don't know what category I put it in. Probably bakery, but it's also a bit confectionery. So let's talk about the scent description. Scentsy says, a bewitching blend of apple drizzle, roasted pears, and cinnamon bark. Before we break down the notes and what I thought of the scent and how it did for me, I'm just gonna tell you this is a super controversial scent. People either hate it or love it. I am not in either of those camps. I just don't get this scent in terms of it's a strange combination of scents, but I'll tell you what I get and that might help you guys decide if it's gonna work for you. All right, the first note we get is apple drizzle. To me, the apple is like a green apple, a little bit crisp, type of green apple. However, it's like the green apple was on the ground for a little bit and it started to not really rot, but it wasn't at its best, if you get what I mean. So that's almost like a fermenting type of slightly green apple scent. Huh. Now the caramel part, to me, it's a very ooey gooey liquid yellow type caramel, one that you would get in a squeeze bottle for sundaes. It's not dark and rich or anything like that to my nose. The second note they talk about is roasted pears. I don't really get roasted pears. What I get is kind of like a pear jelly bean candy. It kind of reminds me a little bit of the pear and the jumping jelly bean candy mixed with that caramel apple drizzle type scent. The caramel apple, I feel like you get the most. The pear jelly bean, I get probably the second most. The last note is cinnamon bark. Now cinnamon bark, I don't really get per se, but I think I'll read to you what I've looked up about cinnamon bark and we'll factor that in towards later in the warming. This cassia bark, sometimes known as cinnamon bark, also known as Chinese cinnamon, commonly used in curries and savory dishes. Says cassia is often known as cinnamon bark and differs from true cinnamon. Cinnamon is commonly available as ground cinnamon and cinnamon quills or cinnamon sticks. These are both true cinnamon. Cassia, on the other hand, which is the cinnamon bark, is a different bark from the cinnamon family. Cassia contains almost the same set of cinnamaldehydes and other essential oils as cinnamon, except that cassia is a lot stronger. Now let's read the bottom part. It says cassia is used rather than true cinnamon in savory Indian and Chinese dishes. You can use cinnamon bark to add flavor to any spicy dish. For example, you can pop a stick of bark in the pan while stir frying and add it to basmati rice when cooking. Okay, so from that we get that the cinnamon bark is different from our traditional cinnamon. So remember that when we talk a little bit more later. All right, so let me just tell you what I get from the scent. I get that slightly apple that's not at its best with a load of caramel drizzle. Then I get the jelly bean. And then I get two other things. So imagine someone like Jabba the Hutt was eating a meal. I picture someone very, you know, wanting to eat a lot of food. So we'll go with him because he's an not a true person. So we're not going to offend anybody. But Jabba the Hutt said, bring me a caramel apple. So they bring him a caramel apple. He doesn't care that it's partially going bad. Lots of jelly beans. Bring me some of those too. So that's what you get at the beginning. He gobbles them up, but there's still that caramel apple smell on the plate. Because first, when you warm this, the jelly bean kind of leaves the quickest, in my opinion. After about 6 hours, he wants some more food. So they use the same plate and they bring him some honey buttered rolls. because that's what I get around hour six. I get a little bit of that caramel apple in the background, but I get honey buttered rolls. He eats all that. Then he says, bring me more food. Now, this is what my husband said, and this is what, you know, it kind of made me laugh. He goes, what do you have going in the room over there? I go, oh, it's casting spells. Do you like it? He goes, it smells like Kraft dinner. So at the end, Jabba the Hutt is having Kraft dinner. Now, I went in and I said, oh my gosh, it kind of does smell like Kraft dinner, but not Kraft dinner that you make fresh, Kraft dinner that's been sitting on the plate for like a couple hours and it has that weird, cheesy, starchy kind of pasta smell. So picture all those scents together. So I think that cinnamon bark is maybe reading like a weird spice with that kind of bread note that I'm getting. I'm not really sure, but yes, kind of a caramel gooey apple, green apple that's a little bit overripe, a little bit of a jelly bean pear, then I get honey butter rolls, and then I get Kraft dinner that's old, and that's because my husband kind of put that in my head. So is that a terrible scent? I just don't think it kind of works. It didn't like turn me off that I wanted to take it out of the warmer, but I also don't want to repurchase it. So how did this do? Well, I put two cubes in Drew's room. I left it going a full 24-hour time frame, starting one morning, taking it out the next morning. I will say at the beginning of this, it overtook Mocha Doodle in my open layout. So Drew's room is just off my open floor plan, and you could smell this like coming out. Then I put three cubes in my bonus room, and I got 8 out of 10 strength and throw. I should say in Drew's room, it was also 8 to 9 out of 10 starting out. It did kind of dip quickly. After that pear jelly bean left, it started to dip. But the apple is so strong that it kind of carries it through quite a bit. I left it going in my bonus room 2 days, 22 hours. At around the 16-hour mark, I had that it was about 4 out of 10. So just keep that in mind. Yes, if you're someone that likes sweet confectionery, very, very sweet to start out scents that turn into starchy weirdness, you might like this. And I think the part that I really don't like is it kind of reminded me of a little bit of Perfect Pumpkin Pear towards the end. Something in this scent reminds me of something in Perfect Pumpkin Pear. Is it the pear? Is it that weird cinnamon bark? I don't know. But I think if you don't like this, put it in a big zone, you won't pick up as much on the notes, and it will actually seem to wear off quite a bit faster. Now, even if you don't like this, to me, it was only about a day and a half to a 2 day scent. So keep that in mind. Will I be repurchasing this? No, it's not really something that I liked. I didn't hate it. I just don't really get it. It kind of reminded me of that weird, you know, it doesn't really mesh with fairy tale pumpkin. All those fairy tale pumpkin notes kind of didn't mesh for a lot of people. And that might be the case for this, but there's definitely a group of people that love this one. So that is casting spells. All right, let's move on to scent number two for the week. It is Iced Pine. So this is current in the catalog. On cold sniff, it's pretty strong. I would say medium to medium plus. And this is in the Woods family. Scentsy says, as refreshing as a walk through newly fallen snow, green fir and pine kissed by icy peppermint. So it's definitely a refreshing scent. It's a pine heavy scent. I would say mostly pine, a tiny bit of fir. Those two tree scents make up about 80% of the scent for me. And then you do get a cooling peppermint kind of in the back, about 20%. There's something to note about the peppermint. I will talk about that here in a second. I just want to say, for me, most tree scents, I can go with any of them. I don't really care. I'll pick, for one, I have a hard time differentiating different tree notes, especially if they're blended with other tree notes. So, but I do really like Ice Pine. It was my favorite scent in tree. So let me tell you, after about a day of it warming, the tree really dissipates and you get a very pretty kind of slightly tree with a really sweet candy cane like note. I've never actually really picked up on that before because I usually always warm this in my big area, but because of the tester Tuesday, I warmed it in a small area because I had all of these testers to use up. There's a lot. I think there's 16 or 17. So quite a few testers. So I will quickly go over how it did in most of the areas I warmed it. So I took three cubes equivalent, put it in my son Drew's room. I had it going there for 1.5 days, about 26 hours. That's where I picked up on the really pretty candy cane toward the end, which I really liked, but then it kind of dies quick after that. But strength and throw starting out at max was about 8 out of 10 there. I put equivalent of 1 cube in my mudroom laundry room in a mini warmer. Strength and throw was maybe 7 out of 10, maybe 7.5. And I left going 2 days, 20 hours there. So it was really nice to come in the house and kind of smell that. It was pleasant. I did decide to put the equivalent of 5 cubes in my open layout. I would say starting out there, it was about 7 out of 10. Now I will say I went nose blind there really quick. So I don't know if it's just the day. I was making samples that day, which can kind of probably confuse one's nose, but didn't do as great as my open concept as it has in the past. And some of the testers didn't quite smell as strong as I'm used to. So I did not actually warm any of my bar. In the last place, because I still had some more testers to use up, I thought, let's polish them off. I put them in my bonus TV room upstairs. Strength and throw there was about 8 out of 10 starting out. And again, I left it going about a day and a half. So one thing about tree scents, I do find they wear off quick. They're usually strong out of the gate and then kind of dissipate. There are others that last a little bit longer, like very snowy spruce. But the ones that are kind of true and powerful pine, I find they do kind of wear off quickly. I think if you're someone that likes the new scent Mighty Pine, you would probably like this. That's probably the closest scent. You can warm this in a big area. If you want, you can warm this in a small area. It will feel a lot stronger in a small area. One thing I want to say is I haven't warmed Black Forest Pine yet, but I did warm Mighty Pine on the weekend, and I absolutely really, really like that one. It smells like a true natural, I'm out in the forest with the crisp air kind of pine. This one smells like you took pine and mixed it with something that's like a candy cane, which doesn't really technically go together in real life unless you're kind of a wax vendor blending scents. But will I be repurchasing Ice Pine? I will probably repurchase it. If they swapped out Iced Pine for Mighty Pine, I would definitely pick up Mighty Pine instead. All right, so let's go to the portion of the video where I'm gonna draw 6 cents and you guys are gonna vote. Please vote by early Wednesday morning down in the YouTube comment section. If you can't do that, oh, don't know what that was. If you can't do that, you can vote on Instagram. It's Patricia Gates and put your votes there. All right, scent number one. Baked apple pie. I'm going in the back. I gotta go quick. I'm on my way to work. Scent number two. What's this one called? Winter pine. Winter pine, which I do have some of that in my Scentsy closet, so I can dip into that if need be. Scent number three. Oh, three, four, and five. Okay. Scent number three is titanium. Oh, we're gonna have to put one back. Scent number four. Red candy apple. I'm gonna put one back because scent number five is going to be Black Forest Pine, scent of the month for December. And scent number six is gonna be our Bring Back My Bar contender. These are scents that are returning in Bring Back My Bar that I do not have Tester Tuesday videos up for yet. All right, scent number six is Blue Raspberry Ice. So thanks for spending the last few minutes with me. I hope you guys have a great day in your neck of the woods. Please take care, stay safe, and I will see you in the next one.